Hello students, so in this class we will see some question answer and we will learn how to write the answer for different type of question like 1 mark question, 2 mark question, 3 mark question, okay? Because you have come now in class 11 and this 11-12 is completely different from your class 9-10, okay? So from the beginning we will learn how to write the answers. So that when you will cross 3 months, 6 months and when you will enter into class 12, there will be no difficulty for writing the answer. Okay, there will be no difficulty to understand that how much we have to write. Okay, so let's start without wasting much time. We can start it. Okay, so yes, so our first question is this. This is one mark question. Okay, you can easily see that this is one mark question. Okay. The dimensional formula of angular momentum. Okay, so write the expression here, L equal to mvr. Now m means, what is the dimension of mass? Capital M. V means lt minus 1 and r means l. So dimension will be ml square t minus 1. So which is the correct option? Correct option is d. If you know the answer, directly you give the serial number and write the correct option, d m l square t minus 1. Okay, if you don't know, then find it. Okay, find it in this way and write the correct answer. Okay, come to the next question. Yes, so our next question is x is equal to at plus bt square, where x is in meter, okay, and t is the time in second. We have to find the unit of b. So this question is related to the principle of homogeneity, okay, in unit and dimension chapter. Here these are the three quantities, x, at, bt square. So principle of homogeneity tells that the dimension and as well as their units, unit of each quantity will be same. Okay, that means unit of x is equal to unit of bt square. Now b equal to what? X by t square. Now what is the unit of x? Meter. Unit of t? Second. So second square. So meter per second square. So correct answer is c meter per second square. Okay, in this way you will write in your exam paper. Okay, come to next question. So hum log ka next question mil gaya. Next question kya hai? Next question hai, the maximum percentage error in measuring the length of side of a square is given. Find the maximum percentage error in calculating its area. So maximum percentage error in length, so delta L by L into 100, this quantity is given, this is 2%. We have to find percentage error of area. Area means what? Area means here L square. Okay, so percentage error in area, so delta A by A into 100, this will be equal to, this power will come out, okay, power will come out delta L by L into 100. Now this bracketed part, delta L by L into 100 is given. It is given as 2%. So 2 into 2%, it will be 4%. So our correct option is this, 4%. Okay. So here you will solve in this way. Okay, you will show the calculation. If you can find it easily, okay, without calculating, just mark the serial number and see 4%. Bas, finished. Okay, come to next question. Our next question is, two unit vectors are perpendicular to each other, find the magnitude of resultant. So two unit vectors means, take one unit vector whose magnitude is 1 and another unit vector means their magnitude will be 1. And the angle between them is given 90 degree. So the resultant will be root over a square plus b square plus 2ab cos 90 degree. Now cos 90 is 0. Cos 90 is 0. That means root over 1 square plus 1 square. That means root over 2. So correct option is c, root over 2. Okay. So two unit vectors perpendicular to each other, magnitude will be root over 2. Okay, come to next question. Next question is, This is direct question, no need to calculate anything. An object is projected with speed u, okay? In this case, if you know the answer, you can directly mark it, okay? Because here nothing to calculate. So this is the projectile motion, okay? This is the projectile motion. Here the initial velocity of projection is given u and the angle is given theta. What will be the velocity at maximum height? At maximum height, what happens? Y component, vertical component becomes zero and horizontal component remains same, which is equal to ux, that is u cos theta. So finally, v will be what? Root over vx square plus vy square. That means you will get u cos theta at maximum height. Okay, at maximum height u cos theta. So this is our answer. Directly you write c u cos theta. Okay, because no need to calculate it here. Clear? Okay, come to next question. So हमारा next question क्या है? Next question मिल गया, एक प्यारा सा next question. Write dimensional formula of force. Okay, so force, write the formula first of all, mass into acceleration. So dimension of force equal to dimension of mass into acceleration, dimension of mass m, acceleration lt minus 2. So dimension of force is mlt minus 2. You can directly write that dimension of force is mlt minus 2. If you know, you can directly write. Okay, come to next question. These all are one mark question. Okay, for that reason you don't waste much time in this type of question. Maximum percentage error in the measurement of radius of circular ring, that means again delta r by r into 100, this is given. This is equal to 0.25%, right? 0.25% it is given. So find the maximum percentage error in measuring its length. So measuring its length means length. Length will be what? Length means circumference. Length means circumference. Circumference means what? 2 pi r. So there is only one variable r. Here power is 1. Okay. So percentage error delta L by L into 100. This will be only delta r by r into 100. Power is 1. So 1 into this. Now delta r by r into 100 is given 0.25%. So answer will be 0.25%. Okay. Come to next question. So this is our next question. Okay, so our next question is the error in measurement of radius of a sphere is given. Okay, that means again delta r by r into 100, this is given, this is equal to 0.35%. okay, you are asked find the error in calculating its volume. So for sphere, what is the volume formula? 4 by 3 pi r cube. Now 4 by 3 into pi, this is constant part. So delta v by v into 100 will be only one variable, that is this one, right? This is the only variable, r cube. So power will come out, then delta r by r into 100. So 3 into delta r by r into 100 is given 0.35%. okay, now calculate it using your calculator. This will be 3 into 0.35, so you will get 1.05%. okay, so answer is 1.05%. okay, come to next question. So our next question is this. Next question tells that two forces of magnitude 10 newton acting at 30 degree with each other, find the magnitude of resultant force. So resultant force, write the formula. F r equal to what? Root over F1 square, F2 square, 2 F1, F2 cos theta. Theta means 30 degree. So root over F1 square, F2 square, 10, so 10 square, 2 into F1, F2, 10 into 10, 10 square, cos 30 is root 3 by 2. That means you will get 10 square plus 10 square, that is 200 plus 100 root 3. 100 root 3. So if you use your calculator, 200 plus 100 root 3, then square root, you will get 9.32. You will get 19.32, but don't forget to write the unit Newton. Okay, so this is the answer. Okay, come to next question. Yes, next question is find one vector which is perpendicular to both the vectors A and B. Okay, A is 2i cap, B is 4j cap. Here also no need to calculate, because A i cap means along x axis, and j cap means along y axis. Okay, this is j cap and this is I cap. Okay, now there is another axis, we all know another axis, this is x, this is y. Another axis is z axis will be perpendicular to x and y. So if x and y are lying on the plane of board, z will be perpendicular to the board. Okay, perpendicular to the board. So perpendicular to a and b vector means it will be any vector which is along z axis. Means k cap will be there. Then any number you can put, all the vectors will be perpendicular to here A and this B. Okay, any vector, like example 2k cap. Okay, like example minus 3k cap. Okay, any value you put in place of C, anything, fraction, positive number, negative number, whatever. Okay, but k cap should be there. Okay, so this is again just one more question. Just one word answer you can tell. If you write 2k, correct answer. Minus 3k, correct answer. 8k cap, correct answer. Okay, so come to next question. Next question is this: A cross B equal to AB, then what is the angle between A and B? So A cross B, mod A cross B, we can write AB sin theta. AB sin theta equal to AB. Now AB cancelled out. AB cancelled out means sin theta equal to 1. Sin theta 1 means what? Theta equal to 90 degree. Okay? Clear? So this is the answer. Okay, so we have solved few questions which are 1 mark question. Okay, 5 MCQ and 7 short question. Now come to little bit lengthy problem, big problem. So agya, wo lengthy problem, wo big problem. Okay, but not so big. Just we'll write to the point answer. Okay, so energy equation is given, E equal to h nu. Okay, h is Planck's constant, mu is frequency. We have to find the dimension of h. So E equal to h nu, it is given. First of all, we'll write the equation for h, that is E by mu. Now dimension of h means dimension of E by dimension of mu. Dimension of E means energy. Take any kind of energy, or you can take work done also, because energy and work done has same unit, same dimension. And frequency means second inverse, so time inverse. So it will be m l square t minus 2, and when this minus 1 will go up, it will be minus of minus 1. So at the end it will be m l square t minus 2 minus minus plus 1, that means minus 1. So this is the dimension of Planck's constant, and its SI unit will be energy by frequency. This energy by frequency, energy means joule, frequency means 1 by second. 1 by second means second will go up, so joule into second is the answer. Okay, come to next question. So next question aa gaya board pe, dikh raha hai sabko? Yes, dikh raha hai, right? So physical quantity S is given in this way, A square by B. Okay, now percentage error of A is given. Percentage error of A is given 2%, and percentage error of B is given 3%. We have to find percentage error of S. Now percentage error of S equal to, this power will come out, 2 into percentage error of A, then always plus. Okay, now whatever the quantities are there, here two quantities A, B, for each quantity the errors will be added, and here power of B is 1, so 1 into percentage error of B. So 2 into percentage error of A means 2 into 2% plus 3%, so answer will be 7%. Okay, This is question number 1. Now question number 2. Length of rod is given in this way. Find percentage error in its length. Percentage error means delta L by L into 100. Now delta L means this is delta L, 0.2. This is delta L. So 0.2 by L. L means mean length. This is mean length, 16 into 100. Okay. Use calculator. So 0.2 into 100 by 16. So you will get 1.25%. Okay. So this is our answer. Clear? Come to next question, everyone. Yes, again, next question. Next question. Next question, make diagram bhi hai. Okay. A vector r equal to 20 meter. So magnitude of this vector is given. At an angle 13.7 degree with respect to y-axis, find the components of along x-axis and y-axis, that is rx and ry. Okay. So components. Okay. So I told already that the resultant will lie between the components. Resultant will lie between the components. That means for this vector, one component will be along positive y-axis and another component will be along negative x-axis, right? Negative x-axis and positive y-axis. These will be the two components. Resultant is in between the two components. So ry iske sath angle hota hai, wo kya hota hai? Cos theta. So y ke sath angle hai, so y ho jayega cos theta. So r cos 37. Now r is given 20 and cos 37 is given 4/5. So 5 4s are 20, 4 4s are 16 meter. Similarly rx will be sine component, right? R sine 37. Here no, we will not put positive negative sign, just we are finding the magnitude. So 20 into sine 37 is 3/5. So 5 4s are 20, 3 4s are 12 meter. Okay, so this is our question number 1. Question number 2 is you have to express r vector in terms of unit vector. So r vector means rx I cap plus ry j cap. Now rx i cap means rx is in the negative x-axis, so it will be okay, just I am erasing this part, just wait. Yes, so rx will be rx then minus I cap, right? Because it is along negative x-axis. So rx is 12, 12 into minus I cap, that is minus 12 I cap plus 16 j cap, this much meter. Okay, bas, finished. Third question is find unit vector along r. For unit vector, write the formula first. R cap is r vector by r. So this is magnitude of r. Magnitude is already given 20. No need to find it again from the second equation. So here put the equation, that means put the vector 16 j cap by r is 20. So it will be minus 12 by 20 I cap plus 16 by 20 j cap. So it will be minus 3/5 I cap plus 4/5 j cap. Okay, done. So these are three questions. Question number 1, components. Then 2, express r vector in terms of unit vector. And then unit vector along r vector. Okay. Come to next question. So this much you have to write. You will get 1 mark. Okay. Next question. So next question again. Next question kya hai? Next question hai, car is moving with 16 meter per second towards east and takes a sharp turn towards north at 12 meter per second. If it takes 4 second in taking turn, find acceleration vector. Okay. Both the value and direction in terms of northeast, northwest, southeast, southwest. And you have to solve this problem using parallelogram law. So first of all, we'll draw the diagram. Okay. So the diagram will be like this. So it is going first of all towards east, 16 meter per second. Then north, okay, north it is 12 meter per second. So this is VF, this is 12 meter per second, and this is VI vector, this is 16 meter per second. Okay, so if we want to find the angle between two vectors, just take it in this direction, because we have to join head to head or tail to tail. Now tail to tail, so angle is 90 degree. Okay, so acceleration means we'll find the magnitude of acceleration. So magnitude of V final minus V initial, right, by time. Now V final minus V initial means we have to take VI in the reverse direction. So reverse direction means, reverse direction means, just one second, yes, reverse direction means the direction will be in this direction now. Okay, this is the actual direction towards east. Now it is minus VI. Okay, now complete the parallelogram. This is the parallelogram law. Complete the parallelogram, then from common tail, common tail, draw the diagonal. From common tail, draw the diagonal. This is the direction of VF minus VI, and also this is the direction of acceleration. Now for VF minus VI, how will you find? Under root VF square plus VI square, then minus 2 VF VI cos theta. Which theta? This theta, not this one, this theta. So this is 90 degree by time. Time is 4 second. Now here cos theta 0, so no need, we do not need this part. So root over VF square, VF square 12 square plus 16 square by 4. Okay, so our answer will be 12 square plus 16 square. So 12 square plus 16 square, 400, that means 20 by 4. We will get 20 by 4, that means 5 meter per second square. Okay, what is the direction? Direction is in this direction, okay, towards VF minus VI. This is which direction? Northwest. So direction will be northwest. Okay, clear? So we have to draw the diagram first of all, then this much calculation. This total 3 marks. So how much thing you have to write? Nothing much. Okay, you have to draw the diagram nicely, then use the formula, find answer, and write the direction also. Bus finished. Okay, come to next. Yeah, so our next question is this. Next question tells that force is given, okay, this much newton, and displaces a block by a displacement is this. What is the work done? So first question is work done. So for finding work done, you have to keep in mind the formula. Formula is F dot product S. Now F is given 2i cap minus j cap plus 2k cap dot product I cap plus 2j cap plus 0.5 k cap. Okay, after that we have to multiply the similar terms, 2 into 1, 2 minus 1 plus 2, that means minus 2, then plus 2 into plus 0.5, so plus 1. So answer is 1. What will be the unit? Joule, or write newton meter. Okay, this is the first part. Second part, find angle. For finding angle, we will use this formula, dot product formula, F dot S equal to F S cos theta. Now F dot S, this part we know, okay, here we have calculated 1 equal to F S cos theta. Now cos theta equal to what? Cos theta equal to 1 by F S. Now F means what? Magnitude of F. So magnitude of F means 2 square plus 1 square plus 2 square, 2 square plus 1 square plus 2 square into magnitude of S. Magnitude of S means 1 square plus 2 square plus 0.5 square. So after that cos theta, cos theta will be what? Find the value. So 1 by the first under root part is 3 by root over 4 plus 1 plus 0.5 square. okay, so it is 0.145. So 0.145, then theta equal to cos inverse 0.145. So cos inverse answer equal to 81.63. So answer is 81.63 degree. Okay, so you have to do this much, you will get total 3 marks. Okay, clear? Come to the next question. Yeah, so this is our next question. Okay, and this is our last question for today. Okay, so next question and last question for today. Okay, so two vectors are given, we have to find A cross B. You all know how to find. First of all, we'll write in matrix form I J K. That means first of all, for A vector, I cap means 1, J cap 3, K cap 2. Then for B vector, 3, 1, 2. Then how to find I cap? Then 3, 2, 6 minus 3, 2, 6 minus 2, 1, 2. Then minus J cap, plus I cap, minus J cap. Minus J cap, then 1 into 2 first of all, that is 2. Then 3 into 2. That means minus 6. Then plus k cap. Plus k cap means, yes, plus k cap means, so 1 into 1, that is 1, minus 3 into 3, that is 9. So after that you will get 6 minus 2, 4 I cap. Here 2 minus 6, minus 4, minus minus plus 4, so plus 4 j cap. Here 1 minus 9, minus 8. So this is our question number 1, done. Question number 2, what is question number 2? Find the magnitude of A cross. So magnitude of A cross B. What is A cross B? This is the A cross B. So magnitude means under root 4 square plus 4 square plus 8 square. So you will get root over 4 square, 16 plus 16 plus 64. So you will get 96. 96 means you will get 4 root 6. Okay, so this is the part. Okay, only this much you have to do. Okay, for 3 marks, 2 marks for first part, 1 mark for second part. Okay, clear? So this much for today. Okay, we have discussed few basic questions. These are basic questions, and we have discussed how to write the answer. We have learned today how to write the answers in the exam paper. Okay, so keep practicing in this way and keep watching my videos. Okay, so in the next day again I will come with few more questions. So thank you everyone.